Now I would like to say welcome to the talk. It's about 13:30 now. Fitz, are you there?
Yes. You can hear me?
Fitz, yes, I can see you. Please.
You can hear me?
Yeah, now we can. Thank you very much. Okay. Welcome, Fitz, and we also forward to your presentation about wind measurement. The floor is yours. Please go on. Hello, Fritz.
Yes, I think the laptop needs some time. That's it?
Yes, that's it. Yes.
And that's nice. Before I start my presentation, I would like to say it's not really the presentation I had in mind. It's still an ongoing research, so I'll show you what I discovered until now. It's due to COVID-19. I didn't get my new measurement instruments in time. My newest instrument, I got it last Monday. And I told a friend who advises people buying a small windmill, he asked me what wind measurement systems should I buy. And I said to him, well, you advise people what small wind turbine shall I buy? And I said, it's the same with a system measuring wind. And it's made from a point of view of a consumer. On the left on this sheet, you see a sign. That's a Dutch sign. It was a little bit of a joke on one of the meetings last year, and it's a sign to let the surrounding the people around you know that you are measuring the environment. Well, I will tell you something about wind measurement and the difference also between real systems and what I call gadgets. I will also focus a little bit on other parameters. I will tell you a little bit about my own experiences, some other technical issues, and then for further reading, I have some resources and links. Well, there's more on the market on a budget. I will come on later on what's on a budget, then on the professional market. So there's a lot of cheap gadgets. First question is, if you want to know exactly the wind direction and the wind speed, because in this budget section, there's a lot of more measured. And then all the other parameters you are measuring, they don't harm, but you have a cheaper system. And all these other parameters are just nice to know if you like them. Well, the goal for me was a focus on price and then focus on the system. Then you have to be aware, there's a lot of marketing around. Is it inclusive, the mast? Is it inclusive, the cable? Does the software cost you extra? How is the measurement system powered? Is it by solar or by batteries? Then you have a question about data. Is it online? Is it free? Is it open source? Is it wireless? And then I'm taking part in several citizen science projects, and all these data is open source. So that's also, if you have data from your wind measurement system, do you give it to the world? Are you contributing to the worldwide database? Well, as I said, if you want to measure only wind speed and wind direction, there are several instruments on the market, but the market is mostly focused on systems that are called automatic wind systems with more measurement options in it. And then I place there, don't forget water. In my situation, when there's a big rain, our street is flooded, even as much as it rainwater comes out of our toilet. So people who know me better know that I have also a rainwater project. And for this rainwater project, it was interesting to know how much rain is falling. So for me, there was more or less a choice to go to measuring with an automatic wind system. But there are a lot of places worldwide where water is also a problem, and or where water has more taxes. So water is one of the first extras that come in mind by buying in the system. Well, on the market, there's a term that's called 5-in-1. That means that you are measuring wind speed and direction. You're measuring temperature, humidity, pressure, and rain. And sometimes this also called all-in-one. Then some stations measure UV and light. Some stations have also the possibility to have substations in the house, also for temperature, humidity, and pressure. And some of them also the possibility to measure CO2 and sound. And for instance, Davis has also a system that measures fine dust, which you can measure in the house as well as outside. I have some links at the end of the presentation. Well, focusing first on price. You have to ask you what can you afford and what do you need? Well, I discovered if I made several ranges, a very cheap range from 50 to 100 euros. Most of these gadgets don't give data usable for your computer. Then you have a range from 100 to 250 euros, a range from 250 to 1,000 euros and above 1,000. And there were, that is where I made the split. I made an overview of all the suppliers on the market. It will be also included in this presentation, and that's where I made the split. So above 1,000 euros, I don't mention. It's only on a budget, so the lower priced. Sometimes on the market, there are close out deals. That means that a system will be no longer on the market, and the rest of they want to sell at a lower price. It can be interesting. What do you want? intended was measuring wind speed and direction at the place you want to install your wind turbine. You want to log your wind speed and wind direction. You want the storage of data, and then at least at low cost. The data you get should be downloadable, for instance, for an Excel sheet. It should be safe hardware and software. There's a lot of cybersecurity when you connect devices to the internet. And you want to have a secure data connection. I encountered several loss of data because I used a wireless connection. Wi-Fi, you can't trust Wi-Fi connection. And when it's the connection is lost, you don't get an email or a phone call from your device that you are missing data. Well, my own situation, it's my the last one is my fourth measuring instrument. The first one was from 2008. I have two photos here. On the left one, on top, that's the Nitatmo. Here, at some lower on this disc, is the UPM from 2008. And then, no, on the top is the better generation. And then here it's hard to see, but here's a pole. You see, it's just half of the houses, one third of the distance to the top. There's my Nitatmo. And I have a special reason to have it there. I will come back on that. It's very cheap gear. That's why I call it gadgets. There was a discussion about you can better have several instruments, because if one is broken, you can change it. Now, forget it. If you want to change it, it's out of the market and it doesn't fit on the system anymore. It's the same in automatic weather station, all in one. If one of the products is gone, you have to throw away the whole product. That's the same. So it is a product, is a gadget, it's a product, you throw it away when something doesn't work anymore. So I will come back later on that. Well, my first one. You can see it on the left here as a station inside. There are some, you need some batteries. And that was the first problem I encountered. You see, it's on the roof. It's a rental house. So I have to go through other ones, living room to go up to the roof. Well, I have to change it every, let's say, 3 to 6 months. So that's a problem. I have to make an appointment with my neighbor. So I learned from this, should be an independent power source. Second thing I encountered was Wi-Fi didn't make it. So I placed an antenna and an antenna cable near the sensor. And I soldered, you can see here in the middle on the other side, I soldered this antenna cable in this unit. This cheap one has also an outdoor unit measuring humidity and temperature. And here are the batteries after 1 year. First, I placed batteries in it. After 2 months, I had to change it. And again, after 2 months. So I placed rechargeable batteries in it. And then after a year, I opened it and this is what I saw. So it's not watertight. So that's it's low quality. It's cheap, but low quality. Well, Better Generation was a product that came on the market in 2009. I was one of the first. As a Kickstarter, I could buy it for 100 euros. They're still on the market. Better Generation itself is out of the market. This was a system in which the data was locked on an SD card, as you can see here in the middle. And from time to time, you had to put out the SD card, put it in an adapter, and you could go to the website. And it was intended to get some marketing from buying a small windmill at that time. Well, the advice was just put it on the roof, leave it there for a year, and then after a year, you have all the data on this SD card. Well, I did so, and after a year, I put it down, and then it only measured for 2 months, because they had a battery in it that was probably too cheap. I ordered, you can see it on the right, I ordered from this company 30 meters of cable, and I now have this in my working room. With 30 meters cables. You can also see on the right above that was after a year, as it's damaged from the heat. It was also not watertight anymore at that time. Here on the left, you can see it as new, white, and the sun has also after 1 year had a lot of influence on the casing. And here on the right side, that's the data you get roughly from your SD card. You can also see I had a problem with the switches. So it's a fast repair from my side because the system is also in principle ended yet. Then the third one that came in 2019 was the base is about 250 euros. You get a base station. It's a huge one, and then you can buy three substations, one outside and three substations inside. But the head station plus the out station. That's what one buying. And then I decided to buy one for inside extra. This one I use in my washing room so I can see, for instance, how fast the humidity in my washing room, how good ventilation in that room is working. you can also buy a wind speed and direction meter and a rain gauge. Then my first experience after 3 months was this. On the left you see my rain meter new, and the above it's after 3 months. Talking about accuracy. then later on in the year it was raining and I didn't got measuring data, but the battery was full. And then I put it off the pole, and then on the right you can see the filter was totally clogged. So such systems need maintenance and surveillance. This is an example of the data you get from the Netatmo stations. Well, I try to get out, you will see in the next slide some figures, some pictures, but you can only download 3 months. And I, until now, I didn't succeed in combining it to a whole year to get the data of a year out of it. This is a new picture of this system. When you follow my cursor, you see this is the height. It's especially a special location for me, because here around I have several environmental sensors, and these sensors need power. I can power them by solar, but then I have not enough energy in winter. So I'm working on a wind turbine, don't laugh, with a rotor of 10 centimeters. But I need to know how in this garden, surrounded by huge buildings, is there some wind? And then the next. Well, here you see a graph of the wind for one day. It's the upper one. And you see, you need at least some wind above 5.6. No, it's not there in average. But there are some gusts, and I need not much energy. So these gusts could be enough for me to charge a simple AA battery. The next graph is from a week, and nearly a week, last week. And you see, there are some more gusts in this closed garden. There are some gusts that are about 5.6. This is what you get above 1 month. And this is a picture of a whole year. And even in the summer, I had a peak. If it's accurate enough, that's another discussion. Well, this is my newest one. It was 1.5 years, 2 years ago, a Kickstarter. Weatherflow is I knew Weatherflow already, because I had a wind measurement for my phone from Wavoot. Wavoot was a Danish company that's now out of the market, but this company, Weatherflow, take care of all the clients of Wavoot. So I trusted this company. I arrived last Monday, so next time I will tell you more about this station, and also of the solar power of this station is enough for a whole year.
5 minutes, Fritz.
Okay, I will go through it. Some technical issues. Accuracy, enough is enough. You don't need you don't really need an instrument that is very accurate. Well, mechanical or ultrasonic. Ultrasonic means you have less maintenance. It's said you have less maintenance, but it responds better to rapid wind gusts, and it's extremely precise. Then this one is not from me, it's from Enensis, and they say have two systems, one on the location for a reference, and go around with the other one, so you can look if there are more locations in the urban circumstances which are slightly better. Then you have to look at software updates. It should be automatic. You should at least an email that you have to change your software. Then how the solar power and cloudy weather. And then the problem of wireless between your wired a new wired system between sensor and base station. Well, obsolete, out of stock is also a problem. Don't expect service. There's no long-term support commitment. If you want to do this for a small wind turbine, look at the hub height. Some apps need for your phone need a specific operating system, and the newest at least. Birds from your instrument, I will come back later. Dust dirt, I showed it. And then you can also buy and rent equipment, and that was provided formerly by Enensis in Germany. Well, bird on a vane. I had some on my vanes. I took a photo with my phone, but this photos are much better. You see, you can't measure wind in this way on the left side. Bird droppings on marine, on sailing yards, they have bird deterrents to avoid this. Well, there should be a matrix of gadgets and features and an inventory of experiences. I'm not doing this alone. There are a lot of forums. One was yesterday already. I will show that in the next slide. And there should be an independent open test of all these gadgets with an accurate measurement instrument also included. For universities, there should be an industrial design rules for these gadgets. There should be a student who dives in this. Quality mark is also something to do. And look at the optimal refresh data for small wind. It's important to have all the information I do from the wind gusts. But otherwise, on the other side, you get a lot of information. Well, from these are the resources, but yesterday Louis Villa was had a presentation of wind empowerment, and they have a special working group on wind measurement. So that's what I wanted with this slide. Yes, this is a problem. So I included separate this slide beside the presentation. So it's on the website of the Focus Center afterwards, and you can Google yourself for a next station. Yeah, and if there were a manufacturer of cellular is looking and he wants to donate a product for testing, I'm here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Fritz. It was a really good presentation, and I think that we all got something good out of it. Thank you very much. About the questions and so on, and comments for Fritz Ock, I will ask you to wait till 2:30, where we, because we are 2 o'clock now.